Where do we get the over 145 million specimens and artifacts in our collections? What do we do with them? And what do they tell us about our world? To find out, join us on a virtual tour inside Objects of Wonder, collections from the National Museum of Natural History. I'm Rebecca Johnson, the Associate Director for Science and Chief Scientist at the Smithsonian's National Museum of Natural History. I'm so excited to share this exhibit with you, because collections are the heart and soul of this museum. They reflect our amazing world, inspire wonder, and form the foundation for scientific discovery. Objects of Wonder showcases 1,030 objects from our collections, many of which have never been publicly displayed before. They represent our seven major scientific departments: anthropology, botany, entomology, invertebrate zoology, mineral sciences, paleobiology, and vertebrate zoology. These vast collections continue to grow and are actively used by scientists around the world. They contain a myriad of stories yet to be revealed. Throughout the exhibition, objects and groups of objects tell distinct stories about human cultures, natural phenomena, and the scientific process. For example, the birds of paradise in this case illustrate how sexual selection can result in extraordinary shapes, colours, and behaviours. Other seemingly unrelated objects are clustered together to reveal a hidden connection. The towering Apatosaurus femur is 180 times longer than the hummingbird femur in the same case, but both are dinosaur bones, because of course modern birds are a type of dinosaur. Other items in our collections show how researchers study objects to learn more about the natural world or gain insights into human cultures. This elk bone harpoon embedded in a whale bone both answers and raises many questions about early whale hunters along Oregon's north coast. As collections grow and science progresses, we can go back and study our specimens and artifacts with new questions and techniques, often leading to new discoveries. These striking black and white pots from Chaco Canyon, New Mexico, were excavated in the 1920s. But it wasn't until nearly a century later that chemical residue analysis revealed they once held chocolate, indicating trade networks between ancestral Pueblans and Central American cultures over 1,000 years ago. As custodians of these extraordinary collections, our job is to keep them safe and cared for so future generations of researchers and visitors can study and enjoy them. You can explore any of the exhibit areas not covered on this tour by selecting stops on the virtual tour's homepage.